It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Rahul Swarup Sharma. Rahul Swarup Sharma is an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at University Science Instrumentation Center, DEI. He has been a visiting scientist at RPI, USA, and Center for Metal Farming at Sophia Antipolis, France. His areas of research are study of bulk nanomaterials through severe plastic deformation, multi-scale modeling, intelligent manufacturing, and soft computing. He has incorporated agility in farming industry, a novel design philosophy that is based on intelligent knowledge-based systems for enabling rapid redesign of existing production systems. The main outcomes of the research effort are development and implementation of efficient design methods for producing components by different metal forming processes. He has several ongoing research projects and has also authored several papers in referred journals and co-authored a book. Welcome, Dr. Rahul Swarup Sharma.
So this is a new work that we have started at this institute from last 2 years only. So first I would like to give you a background of this work, where it starts. There is a relationship known as Hall patch relationship in material science, which states sigma v is equal to sigma I plus k . So basically this is a inverse square root relationship, where d is the grain size of any material, polycrystalline material which are available metals. So what it states, that if you are able to reduce this grain size, if you are able to reduce this grain size, you will be able to increase the strength. So this is the entire story behind our work. So our work is basically to reduce this grain size of normal material or readily available material, so that we can increase the strength. Because these metals are being used everywhere in all the commercial applications, and our work has applications in making sports equipment, in medical equipment, and in aircraft fasteners, and even in composites. So the main aim of our work is basically here. Our work is falling here. The metals which are available in literature are openly available in nature. Their crystal sizes in the range of 10^-6. So our approach is to bring these scales to nano level. And the benefit will be that if you are able to bring this level to 10^-9 or nano level, you will be able to increase the strength. And if you are able to increase the strength, the benefit will be definitely what? There will be a lot of weight reduction. The implants which are being used in medical, the fasteners which we are using, orthopedic surgeons are using, of titanium. If the titanium is processed through our process, definitely if they are using a 50-gram nails in the implants of orthopedics, definitely if the metal which is processed by this kind of process will be required of much less in weight, and that too with high strength. So this is what we say it as a bulk nanomaterials. So the approach that we are using to develop these bulk nanomaterials is basically top-down approach. It's not a bottom approach, it's a top-down approach. We will be using, or we are using coarse grain material which are being which is already available, and our approach is to convert that coarse grain material into ultra fine grain material, and if possible to bulk nanomaterial. So what we are trying to do, so this is a classification of different kinds of nanomaterial, and our topic of interest is basically bulk nanomaterials which have to be 3D. This this is a picture just to convince you all from the literature. ECAP is basically equal channel angular pressing. It is one of the techniques for SPD. SPD is basically severe plastic deformation. If you are inducing more strain into the metal, into the material, what we are achieving better strength. But side by side, what we can see, we are compromising at that limit. So, few researchers are also working on this. If they can side by side, at least retain the ductility of the metals or increase the ductility of the metals side by side by increasing the strength. And this kind of work is not a new work. Even the swords which were being made during 300 BCs, they were also made up of bulk mineral materials. It is nothing new. And that was known as Wood's steel. But the time is here, basically we are putting it in a different manner and now we are having a different applications. Now I will come to what are the different kinds of severe plastic deformation processes that are available in the literature. We have equal channel angular pressure. I will go to the figures directly. This is basically high pressure torsion. I will show you the process. So in this case, what is being there? A simple sample is being taken here. It is being compressed from the upper die and some kind of torsional force is applied from here. So what is happening? This kind of approach is taking place. So what is happening? Strain is being induced. As the strain is being induced, definitely what is happening? Their microstructure is changing and their microstructure is changing, it may, and the coarse grain metal is becoming ultra fine grain metal. This is multiple forging process. This is equal channel angular pressing. This is cyclic extrusion compression process, multi-axial forging process, and these are the formulations that are giving for inducing strain. Like in this, strain is given by N 2 by root 3 of what? So the main parameter of the strain is depending on this angle. Two more processes that is, they are available, that is ARV process, accumulative roll welding, and this is repetitive corrugation strengthening. Till now there is no any commercialization of these processes being done. There is only one process which is showing some kind of commercial viability, that is ECAP process. The problem with this process is basically the sample size is very small, the metal that will be available will be very less. Same is the case with, we cannot do this process continuously because again the main kind of process is taking place over here. This process is also bulky and again it will be done in a discrete manner, not in a continuous manner. In this case, what is happening? If you do rolling after 2 passes, 3 passes, 4 passes, what will become? The end metal will become very thinner. So the end usage of that metal will be very difficult. Again, in this case also, the end product that we are getting will be in very less quantity. The only best method that is available in this SPD process is ECAP. The beauty of this process is this, we are applying shear strain at this place, and the end product that we are getting is of the same cross section. We are putting the metal over here of the same cross section, say 10 mm diameter or 1 inch diameter, and we are getting the same kind of output over here. So, what I mean to say, if we are putting a coarse grain metal from here and we are getting a bulk nanometer from here of same weight but of high strength. So, this and this specimen or this billet can be further utilized for end applications for making, like it will be a billet, raw material billet, and it can be used for making fasteners, implants, sports goods, anywhere it can be taken. So among all these processes, this is one of the best processes, but again to induce strain, what is required? We cannot get a strain in a single pass. So we have to go for, this I will discuss later. So now my entire work will be on ECAP process. So this process, there are only two main parameters on which the strain is depending, that is this angle and this angle. So our research is totally focused on what is this best angle and what is this best angle that we can get a best strain, highest strain in the material. And I already told you the beauty of this process is that we are getting a metal of same cross section but with different microstructure. So this is a problem with this process. We cannot get uniform strain in one pass. So what we have to do? We have to do one pass, then again put the billet again, then again one more pass, then again we rotate the billet, then again one more pass, then again. So we have a different routes to cover the entire microstructure of the billet. Then again it becomes a very complex process and time consuming process. So again the problem comes of commercial viability. So what we have proposed at DI, can we have in a single die, can we have number of tons? This is a PCAP process which has been proposed by the literature by Segal from Russia. This was invented in 1992. So to overcome that problem, number of passes, can we propose this? Can we propose this 1 ton, 2 ton? And can we propose 3 tons? So what we are trying to overcome is that again and again we don't have to repeat that process. And the end product we can, and this can be continually applied. So then it can be called as a continuous PCAP, and this process has got commercial viability. And what we are getting, in a single pass we are getting strain to 2.3, by this we are getting strain of 3.45. I'll show you some simulations. So some more we have proposed. This is conventional S-shape 3D band, and this again 3-ton PCAP. These are finite element method simulations that you can see. This is a die which we are simulating. This is for aluminium. So this is the area of interest where the strain is being induced, and after that we are getting the same blade over here. Strain is being induced, microstructure is changing, strength is increasing by Hall patch relationship, and again we can put this again, again and again we can get higher strength. So this is the basic process. So that was for square cross section, this is for circular cross section, but different dimension. So our main research at DI is how we are contributing to this field is in ECAP process, and ECAP process also, what will be the best angle? What will be the best 3 tons, 2 tons or 4 tons ECAP, and what will be the best parameters? So we have a setup for this, and apart from this we are doing affine study for this also. This is the region here. Sudden deformation takes place. Immediate. It takes a turn over here and sudden deformation is taking place. This is equivalent strain that is being shown. So average we are getting around 1.41. But to get a uniform, again we need to have different number of passes. This is without die, only billet I have shown. This is how it is being compressed, deformed basically. Here started, deformation started. Now I'll show you that we have done uniquely here. That was 3 ton. The one which I was discussing just now. In a single pass, we are getting 3 passes. Means 3 times work is being done in one pass. And we are able to get up till 4.97. It's going to be up till 4.97 in the case of aluminium. And designing of this die is really very tough. So this was one of the process that we have attempted here at DI, that's ECAP process. the second process, that is high pressure torsion, that also we have tried at DI through FEM simulations. But again, the problem with this, the sample size is very small and there is very less chances of making this process as a commercial process. But I like to show you the simulation of this also. Torque is being applied by the lower die and the sample is here and the upper die is only just pressing it, compressing it. Not compression, basically it is holding it. This is a study we have done for different angles, for different channel angle and for different angle of curvature. I'll show you the results. One more process that we have proposed from here is, that is twist extrusion with E-cap. But what is twist extrusion? This is one more method for getting a high strain. That you are putting a bit from here, you are twisting it, there is a die, then again you are getting it. This is a twist extrusion. So what we have done over here is, we have combined this with E-cap. Here we have applied twist and here we have applied twist. And we are able to get very huge amount of strain. But the end blade that we are getting is not of same cross section. But in E-cap we get an end blade of same cross section. High rate of deformation is taking place. One more process that we have attempted is, that is ARB process. This is simple rolling. But further to that, what we have done, the output of this rolling process is again tried out in this manner. Then again we have taken twice of it and again. But again the problem is of commerciality with this, because at certain end of time this will be reduced. Then how we are going to use that particular thin sheet? So the best method that I will try to convince is, that is E-cap only, in which there are some chances for, or full chances of commerciality. So I'll come back to this part. So these are the various results of our study. To help the community, to help this SPD community, that what are the best process parameters for this E-cap process. We have tried for different die angles, 90, 105, 120, for different frictions. So what is the amount of force? So force is not the criteria for us. The main criteria for us is basically to obtain equivalent strain. So this is for normal E-cap, and this is what that I just showed to you. Hybrid twist extrusion means twist extrusion with E-cap. So in this case, we are getting, everywhere we are getting higher amount of equivalent strain, at least twice in single pass. So these are the results. So this work we have attempted over here. This is the showing effect of friction for different channel angles. CA is channel angle for different effect of friction, means these are tabulated from the table only. These results are for different passes. As I told you, in a single turn, we need to give number of passes. So first pass, second pass, third pass, fourth pass for 90 degree angle, and we have taken only these frictions and how much equivalent strain that we are getting. So in the fourth pass, what we are getting? We are getting 8.4. Means in a single pass, we are able to get 2.49, and we are able to get 8.42 in the fourth pass. But again, the process is cumbersome. If we are able to get this kind, this much of equivalent strain in that multi-turn EKF, that is the main objective with us. So I am showing the work that we have done over here. This is for study we have done for 105 channel angle. This is for 120 degree. This is for hybrid one. 90, 120, 105. These are the results that are compared for HT, is basically hybrid test extrusion, and EKF. So everywhere this is superior. Hybrid test extrusion is superior. So these are the some concluding results comparing for EKF and HT. This is, I am showing to convince you from the data, from the literature, the different number of passes, what we are getting, we are able to increase the tensile strength of any material. But same way, we are compromising with ductility. These are not ours. This is a material, that aluminium with 1% magnesium, 3% magnesium. These are sad patterns. So here we can see ultra fine grains. But this is not ours, this is from literature. In SPTV, we have also tried number of experiments. We have first extruded, then taken a billet. That billet is being used for high pressure torsion. Similarly, one more tried we have tried. So after rolling, we have taken that example and put it in high pressure torsion. These are, so for different three cases, we have tried SPT. That is, we have taken a simple casted sample, a sample which was previously extruded, and a sample which is rolled. So in this sample, we are able to get highest amount of equivalent strain, and this is the running time for torsion, 120 seconds. So this slide shows the impact of this field, how this field is becoming more important, more popular. Every year, two or three conferences are being held on SPD. There is a big group on bulk nanostructured materials, and there are good number of publications in this field. This is the current status, and the summary is, a brief review of various SPD techniques is attempted, and the usefulness of FE software for simulating the SPD process is demonstrated. During the last two decades, several plastic deformation techniques have progressed, becoming a well-established and recognized procedures for achieving very significant grain refinement in a wide range of metal alloys. Thank you.